Welcome to the Take Your Pick podcast, the number one podcast you've never heard of, and I am your host, Nick. Welcome. We just finished week one of the NFL season, and it has been interesting to say the least. I know for a fact I have been disappointed, but not in terms of my fantasy, though. I know some of y'all's fantasy just got busted because Aaron Rodgers got injured last night, and trust me, we are going to dive into that. Honestly, Aaron Rodgers getting injured won me my game last night. So I'm in three leagues. Two out of the three of them, I am winning right now. So I am feeling pretty good. Feeling really good. I know some of you are really down. Time for you to start making some trades. Don't even bother putting Aaron Rodgers on the IR list. Get rid of him. Go ahead and draft somebody else. But before we get into that, we're going to talk about a team that did go ahead and disappoint me. And that is my Pittsburgh Steelers. Look, I was so prepared for this game. We've been talking about this team since last year. You know, we went 9-8 last year, missed the playoffs because we were banking on the Dolphins to lose. They couldn't even do that for us. But we saw a lot of bright spots. We figured, you know what, this is the offense of the future. Our defense is going to be better. We went out and got Pat Pete. Yes, he's older now, but we went out and got Pat Pete. We got Minka Fitzpatrick. He's still there. Cam Hayward. TJ Watt's coming back. This defense is supposed to be elite, right? Then our offense, our young core, the future, Kenny Two Gloves, George Pickens, Najee Harris, Deontay Johnson. I was expecting big things. Now, yes, am I overreacting just a little bit? Yes, I am. We played the 49ers. 49ers are like the favorites to win it all, especially now that Aaron Rodgers is out. 49ers, possibly the best team in the NFL this year. They are loaded over there. But I still expected us to be competitive. We were not competitive. I watched this game. I put on this specific hat right here. I put this hat on. Shout out to my brother for the hat too, man. This hat is fresh. But I put this specific hat on. I had my Steelers hoodie because my wife likes to keep it cold in the house. So I figured I'd rock the hoodie. Had my favorite slippers on. I went and bought a 12-pack of Twisted Tees. I was really, really in the mood to watch some Steelers football. And what did I get? I got a horrendous display of offense, which then impacted defense, which impacted us losing this game. We lost 30-7. We didn't get those 7 points to the third quarter, and we were already down. It was one of those games where if I wasn't a true fan, I would have turned it off in the second quarter. Because at one point in the second quarter, the 49ers had 199 yards. And we had one. We had 1 yard of total offense. That is pathetic. And it's so disappointing because we had such a great preseason. We were so good. We were so good in the preseason. I could see it. Did I think we were going to be a Super Bowl contending team? No. But I thought we'd be one of those teams that teams would fear. That we could be somewhat of a contender. We wouldn't be a wild card team. We might get a bye. Who knows? But no. No. We couldn't get that. Kenny Pickett. I'm not giving up on him. All right. I'm not giving up on Kenny Two Gloves, but until he has a better performance, I can't even call him Kenny Two Gloves no more. It's just Kenny Pickett. He threw for 232 yards, one touchdown. And you're probably thinking to yourself, oh, Nick, that's not a bad game. He threw two picks. It's not good. It's not good at all. If he's going to do that, we might as well play Mitch Trubisky. You know what? There was actually one point in this game. I can't believe I'm saying this right now. Where I was like, where's Mitch? Where's Mitch? Someone could make it end. I could have sworn I was watching Mitch Trubisky out there the way that we were throwing that ball around. He looked so flustered. And he was making such bad reads from the get-go. And it was just downhill from there. Like, there was really no real positives. The only positive for me is that I didn't have him on my fantasy team. But you know who I did have? I had George Pickens. Couldn't get him the ball, so it didn't matter. Also, at Najee Harris. Yeah, Najee Harris got me basically no points. Najee Harris had 31 yards on 6 carries, and one of those carries got him 24 yards. Completely shut out in the first half. This Steelers team completely let me down. Completely let me down. I cannot believe this happened to us. Now, don't get me wrong. The 49ers, they are a stout defense. They are amazing all the way around, okay? They are an amazing team. But I still expected us to put up some form of a fight. And then to make matters worse. Deontay Johnson has a hamstring injury, so I don't even know when he's coming back. So that's one offensive weapon that's already gone. We already were producing, and now it's going to be even worse. Oh, brother. Oh, my gosh. I know one thing, though. I think we play the Browns next game. George Pickens, he needs to have like 15 to 20 targets. That needs to be like the only person you're trying to pass the ball to. We've got to make up for this. But you know what? Even with that suggestion, Matt Canada won't make that happen. He may need to go. His offensive play calling is doo-doo, horrendous, poo-poo, it's trash. This is how I feel about Matt Canada.
Cannot play with him. Cannot win with him. Cannot coach with him. Can't do it.
Absolutely can't do it. He's trash. He's terrible. You know, there was one point in the game that we were in the red zone. I think we're actually on the 8-yard line. Matt Canada calls 4 verticals.
How do you do that? How do you do that? What the hell is going on?
Asking the real questions here. Why are you calling 4 verticals on the 8-yard line? Where are they supposed to go? What kind of play calling is that? But to make matters even more worse for Matt Canada, since we've got him, since he's become the offensive coordinator in 2021, we have yet to have a 400-yard total offense game. Let me repeat that. Since we got him, we have yet to amass 400 total yards of offense. We've also failed to score more than 20 points in 27 of his 36 games. Like,
how do you do that? How do you do that? What the hell is going on?
When we got him, I did not expect this, right? Because obviously we needed better offense because Big Ben was on the decline. He had to go. We're bringing in the young guns. We're expecting new things because we cannot just run Najee Harris into the ground. But this right here, I didn't see this coming. But I expect our offense to end up being better. But if not, Matt Canada, he has got to go. And then we have to look at the other side of the ball, our defense, right? So I mentioned that we got Pat Peaton. Yes, he's an aging cornerback, right? Like, I remember what happened to Richard Sherman. Richard Sherman, he bounced around. Aging cornerback was once great, considered the best corner in the league. It was him and Pat Pete. Pat Pete might need to hang it up soon, man. Look, before the game, he spoke about the 49ers offense and being able to read their offense and that he was anticipating that he was going to get an interception. And you know what happened this game? He didn't get an interception. There was not one interception to be had by Pat Pete. Rather than get an interception, he decided that he was going to let Ayuk cook him all game. Ayuk was catching everything on Pat Pete. Everything. The Pat Pete probably shouldn't open his mouth anymore because he's not the elite cornerback. His name is bigger than he is now. And that's unfortunate because we need great corners. We need a great secondary. Fitzpatrick can't do it by himself. He just can't. As great as he is, can't do it by himself. And then, of course, I expect Cam Hayward to be there to help TJ Watt on that line, only for him to get injured too. And now he has to have surgery and is expected to miss about 8 weeks of football. Sorry. I'm getting really worked up right now. Getting really worked up. You know, I don't want to just keep focusing on the negatives. Let's talk about something positive that happened yesterday. And it took me a little while to figure out something positive that happened. So TJ Watt was like the only bright spot. He had 3 sacks and 2 forced fumbles. So thank you, TJ Watt, for showing up. But the rest of the team did not. Okay, so we still allowed Christian McCaffrey to run for 152 yards and a touchdown.
How do you do that? How do you do that? What the hell is going on?
Oh, and I cannot forget Mr. Purdy. Mr. Purdy threw for 220 yards and 2 touchdowns as well. Pittsburgh. Please pick it up. I hope this is not the year that Mike Tomlin finally has a losing record because our offense is looking fraudulent. Our offense is looking fraudulent. You know, this is how I feel about our offense.
We have been hoodwinked, bamboozled, led astray, run amok.
Yes, we have all been led astray and bamboozled. I expected more from us. But look, again, like I said, the 49ers are probably the best team in the NFL this year, okay? We are most likely never going to play a team as good as them, all right? That is what I can take away from this. And so, yes, we have the Browns in week 2, but the Browns are coming off a dominant win against the Bengals, and this is not going to be a cakewalk at all. I expect this to actually be competitive. If you would have asked me this a week ago, I would have said, no way, we are going to dog walk the Browns. But that does not seem like it's going to be a possibility.